I can't wait to see what wonderful art you make, Christy.
I've been waiting months for this baddie to be in my hands. If you don't know Moira Elizabeth, where have you been? Seriously though, she created these books. They're called Create This Book. And it's basically designed to put your creativity on overdrive, and it works. Di from the Aussie Crafters, she got this incredible brainchild about having a bunch of artists, 50-ish, come together and assign each other prompts from this book. And then each artist gets to pick their own prompt. And well, as you can see, all the artistic love has been happening in this book. And it's finally here, and I get to work on my prompts. So unlike the other artists, I'm going to reveal the prompt that I chose for myself first. Probably because I am most excited about what's going to happen for the prompt that was chosen for me by Scott. Okay, so create a bird's eye view. I was drawn to this because I knew I'd be able to kind of do a top-down view of some flowers, which is what I love. And I talked a lot about why I chose this specifically in this season of my life on the first of the three lives where I worked on this prompt.
I'm gonna go literal because what does a bird see? Like, and then this morning I was outside, like I said, everything's popping around the house, the patio. I'm surrounded by all these plants. I mean, it is just a comedy of like overjoy in terms of growth and life and it's awesome.
I'm telling you, this whole project was so labor intensive for me, but I wholeheartedly dove right in. You know, as I was painting this one, showing pieces on Instagram, I had so many people reach out to me and say, Christy, are you okay? This is so dark. And I was like, you know what? This is actually more of my typical style when I'm painting just for me. So those messages actually were super cathartic for me to receive because I was like, yeah, I'm doing this thing for me. So the plants that I included in my little jungle scene here were all things that I was seeing and experimenting with gardening or painting. So my Monstera in the bottom right corner, and I have a huge euphorbia. It looks like a cactus, but it's not really one. That's kind of just going across the entire page. And I've got just sweet little dahlias in yellow and begonias. This book is chonky, and we're only what? 11 artists in. I was worried because I use watercolor paper, cold press, thicker watercolor paper. Now, granted, it's not the thickest that I own, but when I had to cut my painting in half and glue it into the book, I was so nervous that it wasn't going to like really adhere, but it did, and it's just fine. And hopefully once the next artist gets it, all will be well. So yeah, and it all just ended up being super kind of bright. Lots of neons, because I'm a neon lover, I gotta admit. I love me some neon. But then I just kept imagining this kind of moody vibe. And that's how the background came to be. Lots of browns, blues, purples, indigos. And this whole thing, to my shock, was mostly done with watercolor markers. I don't know. Let me know. Do you think it works? I really love this piece, but I'm always open for a good conversation about art. All right, create a menu. This was the prompt chosen for me by Scott. And friends, speaking of Scott, who is one of the other artists, part of this huge collaboration here on YouTube, I want you to head into the description later and check out the entire playlist, which is being hosted over on Di's channel, The Aussie Crafter. Because if you're just watching this one first, you got a whole lot to get caught up with. And you know what else you got to get caught up with? That's giving this video a boop. Friends, a boop is a like in watercolor land if you're new here. And by the way, I'm so glad you're here. When I first caught wind of the prompt that Scott chose for me, I kind of choked a little bit. But I was assigned the prompt that was create a menu. Like, I was super nervous. But as some of you know, I have a long history in the wedding industry, 21 years to be exact. And so creating a menu actually for me is kind of like going back to my golden days in the wedding industry. And I felt actually pretty darn well equipped to pull this one off in a big way. So I wanted to find a really cool way to honor each artist that has come before me in this challenge. So Di, the Aussie crafter, had to inspire my restaurant's name. And Rose's gross smoothie. Come on, awesome stuff. Couldn't resist creatively pinging off of Sarah's lovey-dovey characters. Rhea's holy prompt was easy to turn into a dessert. Christine's bubble lion, oh yeah, that was gonna have to turn into a metaphorical bubble tea. Paula's Bobby character made an appearance, holding a salad. Ashley's Dracatoris, oh yeah, dullness for everyone. Kara's anthropomorphic, did I say that right? Tiger woman awesomeness turned out to be my favorite one of all the tiger shrimp. And of course, Shanna, you inspired cloud bread. Tired stuffed shells for Chuck? Nope, we've got stuffed horn. And Scott, we've got a mocha milkshake topped with the newspaper cap or whatever it is that charming thing on your head is. In fact, yeah, we like it. Now, since I drew these so small for the sake of time, we had to do a little cleanup, Photoshop style, and I definitely had to enlist the help of my team over in Weddingland at my other business called Momental Designs. Thanks, Katie! As this menu is being formatted, I kept imagining all of us artists so far in the challenge sitting down to an actual meal and sitting down to see this menu that was inspired by all of our creations, and it definitely gave me the warm and fuzzies, and I'd actually love to see that happen. Wouldn't that be cool to happen, like all 50 artists sit down for a meal after this is all done? Let me know if you want to see that happen. Now, a lot of the work that we do at Momental Designs is actually hand-painted with details after it's printed. So, of course, I had to do a little of that. Lots of white, some golds, and yeah, just sharpen these bad boys up so they looked mwah. Now, the name of my restaurant, of course, inspired by Di from the Aussie Crafter, and I give you the Dining Shroom. Indeed. All right, time to get these bad boys into the book. I cannot believe this is finally happening. But all of this presented to you by, of course, none other than the fabulous Mariah Elizabeth. I'm definitely having a hard time choosing which of the two prompts results is my favorite. And I don't think I can. I don't think I can. What I do know for sure is that this art community, beyond even just watercolor, is such a fabulous, magical, supportive place to be. And I'm honored that I had a small hand in creating this particular book with some very cool new friends.
I can't believe she's finally done. Here you go, Susie.